guys, it's Reagan, and today I'm here to bring you a book review of Jenna / Finn by Hannah Moskowitz and Kat Helgeson. This was sent to me for review by Chronicle Books, and I'm also working with them for this video. Before I even get into the nitty-gritty of this book, I have to say, this book surprised me and surpassed all of my expectations, and I feel like this is a book specifically designed for internet lovers. So starting out with the premise, this book follows two girls, Gina and Finn, and basically the start of their online best friendship. Both girls are heavily involved with a fandom online, which is really close to like the Supernatural fandom. That's kind of what I'm gathering. And they both kind of write blogs or fan fiction, and they find each other online, they start chatting and talking and become very good friends. The format of this book is also really cool because their friendship is entirely online. All of the like writing is through text message or through email or through blog posts, things like that. So the formatting of this book is really, really cool. So the first part of the book is literally just about them becoming friends, fangirling. It's extremely relatable, especially for someone like me who lives on the internet and has countless internet friends and literally has the same type of interactions on a daily basis with people online that in some cases I've never met before. So in that way it's super relatable, and I can bet a lot of you guys can relate to it as well. But this book goes to such a deep place ultimately that I found to be both well done and just a very interesting approach. So first off, the characters of Gina and Finn I found to be great. They're very different from each other, but also very similar. Our main character, Gina, is about to go and start college. She currently goes to a very prestigious high school, and she's ultimately gonna go to a very prestigious Ivy League school. She also deals with some mental issues. She goes to therapy, she takes medication, but she's very open about it. And she puts a lot of stress and emphasis on when she goes to college, her life is going to get better. While our main character, Finn, is a recent college graduate who moved to California to stay and live with her boyfriend, she doesn't have a job and she's trying to figure her life out. So they're kind of at two different places in their lives, but they both can talk and share about their feelings with each other, which is just great. The aspect of this friendship I found to just be unbelievably refreshing. It is a female friendship that is just so deep in understanding for each other that it's just great. And it's also just showing that, like, just because something is online doesn't mean it cannot be real. Like, these people clearly deeply care about each other and love each other, and it's just really, really nice to see this deep bond shared between two females online, between two individuals. Something that started perhaps with fandom talk has turned into life talk, which turns into just understanding each other and a place where someone can go and express their feelings openly without criticism. It's just really, really nice to see. And the part of this book that I really appreciated was it's how it dealt with the concept of love. So love, I feel like in our society, is constantly trying to be defined and put into a box. This is what love means, this is what feelings of love are like, and this is what it means when you love someone. But honestly, love, in my opinion anyway, is a feeling, is a concept that is unexplainable. You, one, can't help who you end up loving, right? Two, you can't understand how it happened, and a lot of times you don't entirely understand the nature of that love. You can love someone deeply and romantically, but it might not be sexually. You could be platonically in love with someone, or you might find them to be part of your family. You love and you care deeply for them, but it might not be romantic. Or it could be romantic, or it's more complex than that, and we have a hard time describing it. That's just it though. Love is something that you can't just put in a box. You can't put love in a corner, it's too hard. And I feel like this book deals with the complex nature of love so well. I mean, the relationship of Gina and Finn gets much more complicated, and ultimately how I feel it happened, I felt like it was very interesting, and I thought it made sense to me. Like, I really liked that, and honestly it was what I was rooting for ultimately. I'm not gonna say kind of how, what goes down in this book, because that would be a lot of spoilers, but I felt like this book dealt with the concept of love so well, and the idea that you can love more than one person in different ways. I just feel like it just dealt with that so well in such a tiny book. Like, this book is short, but it packed a big punch in terms of like dealing with a lot of things. But yeah, this story was just great. It's about two girls trying to find who they are, function in life. They create this wonderful bond and relationship and friendship that is unbreakable and honestly quite inspirational, and I just found it to be really, really touching. I flew through this book because of the formatting, and I honestly feel like this is a book for internet lovers and non-internet lovers, because it just has so much perspective and so much to say. And again, the second half of this book does get quite dramatic and some things happen. I don't want to say what happens because spoilers, but I feel like in that second half of the book, it gets dark and I think it gets really real. So I don't know, I really enjoyed this book. Like I said, it surprised me. I ended up giving it a 4.5 out of 5 stars. I feel like it offered a lot. 10 out of 10 would recommend. Pick this up if you're interested. It literally just came out today. And literally the inside of this book, I just feel like, again, expresses the nature of the story. And my favorite part of the synopsis is, disclaimer, this is a work of fiction and any similarity to real people or events is purely coincidental, which is not to say unexpected. Author's note, fan works matter, fangirls matter, fictions matter, sometimes they get real. Like, it's just, like I said, exceptionally relatable, great story, highly recommend. And like I said, this is actually its book birthday and it actually came out today. So you can go and pick it up, people. Alright, I hope you enjoy. Alrighty guys, that is my review of Gina and Finn. I hope you enjoyed. Like I said, it's a really great book. And I will see you guys soon with another video soon. Goodbye!